Hello guys, on the way of making an autofill form, in the last video, in what we are going to make in this video series is this. We have a form, as user type something, this will automatically search and automatically fill those data. In the last video, we have made this XML layout. So in this video, we will parse that data to populate the result and to filter that result. To filter the result, we will require an array adapter. Okay. So first of all, we need this data. Control Alt Copy. So I am saving this data in a variable, in a private variable. You may obtain this data from some API call or some database call. And for simplicity, I am just saving this variable, saving this data in this variable. This okay. In the last video, we have made this user class. It's nothing but custom data class or Pojo class. Okay, so next thing we are going to do is creating an array list of type user. We will provide this array list to the adapter because adapter needs data. So on that data, it can filter what user is typing. User array list of type user list in its view method. Initialize this user list. New array list. This is an empty. Okay. Next thing we are going to do is to parse that JSON data. JSON string. So I am making a function. That function will return array list of type user. Extract user. Okay. This method will require a string to extract. So I'm making a temporary variable user list. Okay, new array list. Return this list. Okay. So let's create an object. This is an object. JSON object is equal to new JSON object. JSON structure require a map. JSON this. I am providing this string. JSON string. This will throw an exception. Exception when the JSON this string is not a JSON. This will form a JSON exception. So inside this root JSON object, we have whole data. This is a root JSON object. Okay. Inside this, we will require a user data, a user detail, which is a JSON array. So let's get that JSON array user JSON array equal to root JSON array dot get JSON array. What is the name of that JSON array? User detail. User detail. So inside this user JSON array, user JSON array, we have this array. And inside array at 0th index, there is a JSON object. JSON object which have data of user. So next thing we are going to do is to loop through this array and extract those data. So for I equal to 0, I equal to less than user JSON array dot length I plus plus and super. So next thing we are going to do is to get this JSON object from this JSON array. So JSON object is equal to user json array dot get json object at index I. Okay, so this json object contains this ID, name, mobile, email addresses, nothing but user data. So string ID, ID is integer. Yes, ID is integer. Int ID is equal to JSON DO, which is a temporary variable. Temporary is we get this data from JSON array, and now we are getting the ID, name, all that stuff from this JSON array. So JSON object dot get int ID, pass that name of this ID. Next thing we are going to do is to get the name JSON object dot get string. It requires this. Next thing is phone, email, and address. Okay. Phone, email, and address. Yes. So we have this data in the variable, and next thing we'll do is to create a user equal to new user. The constructor of this user will require ID, name, mobile, okay, MOBI, not phone, this is mobile. Mobile, email, and last one is address. And we will add this user to the array user. Okay, this list. So in this way, we have passed this JSON array and put that data in the this array. Okay, array list. So inside on create, let's call this. Inside on create. Extract those data, extract user, and provide this JSON string. This method will require, this method will return the user list. Okay, fine. So next thing we are going to do is to make an adapter class. So let's create an Java class. Name this user adapter. Extend array adapter of user. So there is we need to create a constructor. So there is, I guess, 5-6 constructor, so we'll implement this constructor. Okay, which require context, source, resource, and text ID. No, not this. Create a constructor. Yes, okay. And we want to override the getView method of this class. Okay. So before that, we need to make a raw layout. Raw layout means raw layout that will see that page. This is the raw layout which will show the suggestion. Okay, so we need to provide this raw layout, which is nothing but the XML file. We'll inflate this XML file into this resource. So let's create layout resource file. Let's name that user raw layout. Okay. Change constant layout to layout. I don't know how to implement constant layout. Okay. Text view. Map parent and wrap content id id simple text. Okay, and view to this is the view which separate the data of this from this. Okay, so view with mass parent height. Okay, 1 GB. This is okay. 1 GB. Good. And background of primary color. Set orientation to vertical. Okay. So we have created this raw layout, and in the next video we will complete this video series and we will implement the filter. Okay, thank you for watching.